Hi everyone, I'm Jayne at Rock and Worms. Welcome. Welcome to my castings crew. Welcome to you that if you're stopping by because you're worm curious, you're in the right place, especially if it's regarding red wigglers. Being able to explain the why behind what I'm doing is part of my jam, if that's what the kids are even still saying. But let's get into tonight's video. I am very excited and I hope you will be too. I am moving into a big baby bin for the first time. So meet Orange Julius. Here is my new baby bin. He is a orange crate from one of the surrounding, used to be orange farms. Unfortunately, they've kind of gone away, but I've had this for years. And he used to hold the citrus that was, picked for market by, again, some of the surrounding farms. So I am going to change him into a nursery for my hatched red wigglers. Now, let me start off by telling you what size he is, okay? He is internally 25 inches square. And from the handle to the floor is 8.5 inches. So when you're talking about worms, a lot of times we focus primarily on the square surface area of the bin. And he is 2¼ feet square, okay? So with normal calculations, that means he would take, 1,000, 2,000, 3,000 worms. But because he's deeper, I'm gonna push that limit a little bit over time and see how many worms I can get in here that can exist comfortably and still, grow in and obtain their maximum space or maximum size, excuse me. So what I'm gonna do, so you can stop looking at an empty bin, is the first thing I'm gonna do is put in a layer of my basic bedding. Now my basic bedding, I don't know how much it's gonna take, so we'll probably have to do a couple loads here. My basic bedding is my indoor tabletop pre-composted mix, which I'll link the playlist for how to make that. Mixed in with sifted cow manure because I do have cows on my property. A little spider web there in the corner. I do have cows on my property and I collect and dry and then sift out the cow manure. But of course not everybody has that luxury. Spider web still. So you can just use the pre-compost. Your worms will love that. Or you can mix in other materials such as peat moss or coconut coir or dried leaves. You can work to make your own basic bedding mix, okay? But using the pre-compost as your base ingredient is really, really good because it is just full of biota. You know what? I forgot to put my glasses on, so I can't even see what I'm showing you. There we go. It is just full of biota that your worms are going to tear into and turn into beautiful castings at a rate that will shock you, okay? So using the pre-compost as a base for any mix that you decide to use as your bedding is a really good foundational start. Okay, so I just have a little layer in here. It's maybe 1/2 inch or so deep, okay? Just gives you an idea, okay? And I'm kind of winging this, guys. This is my first time I'm doing this. So I'm gonna be learning. Hopefully you'll be learning along with me and we'll figure it out together. And we'll make changes, As things work, we'll continue it. And if they don't work, we'll stop and figure out something else to do because that's just part of worm farming. And let me mention at this point, again, if you're interested in learning more about how to take care of your worms and, increase their size, their population, their health, please follow along with me and hit that subscribe button. And hit that like button too, because that really helps me. All right, so this is a baby bin. What I just did is scraped off a little bit of the pre-compost that I put on top of it last night. I'm going through all my bins and refreshing them and just making sure they're fed and watered and everything else. And you can see that I just, like I said, I put this on last night, I'm not kidding you. And I just scraped it back and you can already see all the baby worms that have moved from the lower part of their old bedding, which is mostly castings, already up and into the pre-compost I put on top last night. So again, that shows you how much they love that pre-compost. And since pre-compost, you can make it with free ingredients, you know, it's a no-brainer. Really try to start figuring out how you can take advantage of this and make your own pre-compost. All right. So I just want to show you that these are, again, a baby bin. This that you're seeing here, right here, this is worm chow. I added last night to give them a little bit of a feed. I wasn't sure I was going to be able to set up Orange Julius tonight because I was basically hoping to do so for over the past month, get him started, but the stars just weren't aligning. And tonight, the stars mostly aligned, and we're going to talk about, you know, the mostly part of things. So this is, again, worm chow, okay? And I want to show you how many babies are in here. And these are from cocoons from my red wiggler breeder bins. And as you can see, there's so many in here, it would be a good idea to start giving them more room in order to obtain their full growth size. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna dump it into Orange Julius. Let's see if I can do this without, let me do it this way so I don't get the label dirty there. Let's see if I can do this without making too much of a mess. And I'm not gonna clean out the entire bin right now on camera because that does take me like 10-15 minutes to make sure I get all the little babies out, and I don't want to take the time on camera to do that, so you get the essence. Okay, so this is certainly the vast majority of them, but you can see there's still some on the, you know, on the edges here, and that's why it's important to go back and make sure you get everybody. All right, just set that aside. Okay, so here is the first bin full of babies. I'm just gently spreading it out. I'm gonna just kind of do halvesies here because I have another bin of babies I'm going to be adding. I gotta tell you guys, I'm really excited about this. Because my hope is, my hope is that I'm going to be able to add at least 4 total containers of babies into this and therefore be able to use their bins, their regular bins, plus the shelf space they're taking up to move my incoming worms, you know, my worms that need a little bit more attention so I can, you know, chunky them up and get them ready to sell. So by putting more babies in here, I can, you know, use again their space and bins for my older teenagers, if you will. So they can have their own bedroom, right? What teenager doesn't like their own bedroom? So I'm kind of doing that so they'll have the space. All right, so here's the second baby bin I'm going to put in. Again, you can see, let me do it here. You can see how they're starting to move into the pre-compost layer. I should say basic bedding, okay? It is basic bedding. It's the pre-compost and the sifted cow manure mixed together with water to moisten it up. You can see how they're moving into that layer already. And once again, they have the worm chow I gave them last night. All right, so we're gonna dump this in as well. Now, I want to also show you something here, right with this bin that I'm emptying. Oh, I didn't switch ends for the label. There we go. About the bin that I'm emptying out and how it relates to Orange Julius here. Okay. And I do name my bins when I can, like a lot of worm keepers do, because when you have a lot of bins, you need names, because that way they're just easier to remember. We're human. We do better with names than we just do with numbers. It's easier for me to remember Orange Julius than it is for me to remember, oh, he's bin number, you know, 15. So think about naming your bins, if that helps you keep track of them. So this is what I want to show you. When I was talking about the size of Orange Julius being 25 inches by 25 inches and being, you know, 2 1/4 square feet of surface area, is these standard bins that I use are about 2 square feet of surface area, or yeah, about 2 square feet of surface area. So Orange Julius is about a bin and 2/3, a bin and a half to bin and 2/3. So that's why I can add in at least 2 bins from the surface perspective and then start pushing my luck a little bit by taking advantage. Here, I'm gonna put this aside because I'm gonna have to clean out this bin as well. And then start pushing my luck a little bit by using the depth. And I feel comfortable giving this a try because urban worm bags, as an example, or other types of worm bags. People use grow bags as worm bags. They also are taking advantage of the depth. Is this, looks like a little, nope, it's okay. I thought maybe it was a little piece of plastic. I like to pull out the plastic when I come across it. They're taking advantage of the depth of the bag or the 5-gallon bucket. That does the same thing. You're taking advantage of the depth as well as the surface area of the worm bin, okay? So even though this Orange Julius doesn't have a huge surface area, it is significantly bigger than one of my regular worm bins, but it is, you know, 3 times as deep as my worm bins as far as my usage level. So I'm going to, you know, add in more layers of worms until I'm to the point where, like, okay, I'm just overpopulating it. And I don't want to overpopulate. I just want to maximize my population. Okay, so this is almost done, okay? So what I'm gonna do now is I'm just gonna let them settle in for a day or two. Oh, I got a worm stuck on the edge here. I'm gonna knock him down so he can not be by himself. There we go, just a little bit in. So I'm gonna let them settle in. I have, you know, plenty of compost on the bottom. I have the fresh compost or basic bedding. I keep saying compost tonight, my apologies. Basic bedding on the bottom. They also had fresh basic bedding on the top of their worm bins before I dumped them into Orange Julius. So they've got plenty of food to be going on with, along with that worm chow, for several days, again, as they settle in. What my next step in the plan is going to be is to add another layer of compost. And I'm not doing that now. Basic bedding, I'm sorry. I just have compost on the brain tonight. I'm gonna add another layer of basic bedding on top of this. The reason I'm not doing it right now is I kind of just want to watch and see what they do, okay? I'm obviously expecting that they're going to dive down, but I want to be able to easily, you know, pull back where they are and see how thoroughly they're, you know, moving through this bedding material, okay? So that's why I'm not adding more pre-compost, more basic bedding on top right now. But I am going to add a newspaper cover. So
Let me get that right now. And these are the, you know, sale circulars I use for all my bins that fit perfectly on my bins, which I really appreciate. This does not. So in the I wasn't completely prepared vein of life, because like I said, I wasn't necessarily expecting to be able to do this tonight, although I am excited to. I think what I'm going to try to do and see how it works out is I have a big roll of craft paper, brown craft paper, that again, I bought 1,000 years ago that has sat in the corner of the office unused for a very long time. So what I think I'm going to do is cut a sheet of the craft paper to fit, and that will be my new newspaper. All right. And we'll see how the worms like that. Now I'm moving over here out of range for just a second, because I did pick up some of the plastic bags in a little bit of a roll here, so I could keep them more in one piece to make them easier, you know, to take off. And I'm just gonna, because it's the 25 inches is just a little too long for the plastic bag. And I honestly, I think it would be fine, but I wanna be a little conservative right now with covering everything up and making, you know, the worms as comfortable as I can for their first, you know, night or two. But I can already see that I'm probably just going to be able to use, you know, one length of bin and then, or one length of bag and then another length of bag, and not have this dual length to cover that little bit of, you know, opening on the sides. So I think I'm going to be okay, but we're just going to go again conservative right now. All right. Obviously, after I'm off camera, I'm going to take this back off and I'm going to clean out those nursery bins so all those babies do get in here. But I do want you to see what it's going to, you know, what it looks like when it's all finished. All right. I don't know about you, but I'm excited about it, and we'll see what happens, right? So thanks for coming along with me on this. Again, like and subscribe if you're interested in, you know, encouraging me to make more content like this so we can all learn together. If you have any comments, especially about what I'm doing and how I'm doing it, please, please, please share, because this is a new adventure for me, okay? And I, you know, I'm totally open on getting, you know, advice from people who have been there, done that. So you have a good night. I'll see you on the next video. I am yours in the dirt, Jayne.